UFC.com here with Mike Kaney goes up against Kyle Bennett this weekend at UFC Dublin. First of all, Mike, fight week's upon us. How does it feel to be on, you know, one of the biggest cards in European history?
Yeah, no, I'm extremely excited. When I found out that I wasn't fighting on the finale, my manager called me and told me I wouldn't be on the finale, and he kind of let me down. But then he said, but wait, you're going to be fighting on one of the biggest cards happening this year. And when he told me it was going to be Dublin, I was extremely excited because I want to fight in front of these type of fans. Irish people are fight fans, so to be able to fight in Dublin in his home turf is something I'm really looking forward to.
Definitely. And your opponent was mentioned, it was Kyle Pendard. I know you were quite close with Kyle after the show and during the show. You know, how did that feel when the opponent was revealed to you?
Yeah, I mean, it was something, you know, I wasn't really excited about. But wrestling at a high level for a long time, you tend to see the same people at the national level. And it's something I've been dealing with since I was 13 years old. So I've been wrestling friends for a long period of time. In between the bell, you know, it's we're not friends, we're opponents. So it's going to be something I think I'm going to have the edge when it comes to that.
Definitely. You mentioned wrestling there. You know, it's something I think I've watched a couple of your fights on YouTube, your past fights in CFA. People underestimate your wrestling. Is that a fair thing to say?
100%, because I don't use it. I like to stand and I like to strike, and I use my wrestling as kind of anti-wrestling. So if someone wants to try to take me down, it's going to be very, very difficult for them. And when they're not able to take me down, it kind of messes with their head a little bit. So I enjoy using my wrestling to kind of stand up. I like to knock people out. The crowd likes to see it, so that's something we're going to do.
And for you as a mixed martial artist, you know, fighting Kyle, a guy that you grew close to in the house, and you learned, you know, what way he fights, sparring with him, etc., like that. You know, what type of fight are we going to see here? Is there a possibility that the fight might be cancelled out because you both know each other's styles, or are we going to expect something a little bit different?
Yeah, no, I think what you're going to see is, if you watch a lot of Kyle's fights, he likes to try to grapple people in the cage, and I know he's not going to be able to do that to me. So I think what we're going to see is an exciting fight standing. And you see that a lot of times when you have two grapplers that come out to try to grapple one another. They end up kind of abandoning that game plan mid-first round or even at the end of the first round. Then you get to see a really, really exciting fight. I think, you know, if it doesn't end early, I think we have a chance to actually be fighting tonight.
And you're quite a heavy middleweight, you know, you're quite a large middleweight. Kyle's natural welterweight. Do you think that's going to play into your hands come Saturday night?
100%. You know, I think one of the greatest attributes going into this fight is going to be my size and strength. We didn't get to really see a lot of that during the show because I was having to cut weight the entire time. But this, you know, I've had an entire training camp. I've had 8 months to kind of focus on strength and conditioning. I'm leaner and bigger than I've ever been, and I'm in better shape. So I think it's going to be a huge advantage when we come Saturday.
And I presume you mentioned me last week. You were on the podcast with me last week. You mentioned to me that you work with Stephen Wonderboy Thompson, one of the best kickboxers in the world of MMA. Is that type of fight you're going to be looking for, obviously working with him, and you can try to implement the kickboxing elements of martial arts?
That's exactly it. I spent my whole camp there with him, training with his father at Upstate Karate Pitch Black, or Team Pitch Black. And I know that my wrestling ability is going to be enough to kind of avoid what he's trying to do. So we focused on kickboxing, and I think that's what the crowd wants to see, and that's what kind of it's a fan-friendly fight style. And that's what I'm trying to do, is be exciting, because that's what keeps you fighting.
Definitely. So give me a prediction. Sorry, Mike. What's going to go down?
Honestly, I see the first round he's going to be trying to take me down a lot. He's going to get tired, and then he's going to have to abandon that game plan and start striking with me, and then we're going to see an outcome.
And just one more thing. Kyle said in an interview earlier on, I did what him said, you know, he just sees you as an object, not as a person. After the fight on Saturday, you boys going to have a beer?
Of course. We've already talked about it.